Who already knows the ASCII correct?
I think so.
Sort of.
Okay, so good, not bad.
Yes, you know it. Okay, it is a leaping throw. Okay, so you're trying to catch his foot before he puts weight on it. Okay, so technically speaking, the ASCII variety is right across the front, and you're trying to catch. You're trying to catch this. As he's pulling towards you, and he's taking a step, you're trying to catch his foot before it hits the mat. Pure timing. Okay. Some people can do it really well. I'm not one of them. Andre is one of them. He can do it well. Okay. And when he can't do it, he forces it.
He gets it anyway?
Yeah, because his legs have like fingers or something. And they grab your foot and, you know, it just goes up. But anyway. So how you practice it is, of course, you have to pull them so you can take a step, okay? Always important. Remember in judo, you're using your whole body, okay? Kazushi, entry, and execution. A lot of people just concentrate just on the feet, and they go, nothing up here. Then you can do this. Okay. Here, you're pulling, okay? And be sure to keep the grip and follow him down, head up, back straight, so he can take a good fall. If you're like this, he'll take a bad fall, and then he'll pull you. When you're practicing this, remember you have that pull. Okay. Pull. Okay. And it's right across the front. Okay. Now, as far as your feet goes, remember it's not a kick. Turn your foot. Your foot is turned. It's catching him right there. Not up here. Not stepping on his toes. Right there at the top of his foot. Turn, and when you sweep.
Is it right under the ankle? Yes. Is that right under the ankle?
Yep.
I'm going to do it there.
Right there.
See where the red part is on the
foot? Yeah. Right here. Okay. You're not picking him up up over the ankle. You're getting them right there in the top of the arch. Okay. When you do a sweep, you notice I'm not doing this. There's no power if you're bent at the waist. Okay? So you can't do a nice sweep if you're like this. Okay? No power. Sweep. Imagine if you have a broom. Okay? That's the motion you want. When you do the sweep. You've got a broom, you're sweeping. Your power comes from your whole body. Okay. Anything else? Okay. So why don't we pair off?
Could you do it now?
Sure. Oh, one more time?
Okay.
So. And this is important, especially when you're working with somebody. Follow it down, keep the grip. If I don't do this, he could land funny on his back. I'm helping him turn so he can make a nice fall. So when you do this, right? Because I'll fall a little bit. Okay.
What's that? Okay, we should probably turn it off.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Okay, any questions?
Do you sense like you open up your foot a little bit? You have the opposite foot sweep? Give up a little bit of room with your hips?
You might, but you don't have to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because.
Well, it's not that stutter step? It's not like that?
No, not a stutter step.
You
you do that, you expose yourself to being thrown, actually, because you're standing sideways very quickly.
Which foot were you taking first up?
Oh, okay. Whenever you're working out with somebody, usually if you have a right grip, your right foot is slightly forward. Okay? And when they're attacking, they'll usually attack. See?
Okay.
So once you take your grip, he would push. Okay, would push.
Right.
Okay? So it's always in this. When you're doing kata with your partner and Uke attacks, he's always attacking with the lapel hand. So he's going to... Okay? So whenever you're in this position and you want to start moving down the mat, this is first. Okay? Any other questions?
Kata, you're always sweeping the Akita.
This is not throw from kata.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not a kata.
Oh.
This is not in the kata.
Ah.
The next one is, but not this one.
But the principle is the same.
Yeah, the principle is the same.
You're always sweeping the sweep hands.
No, the principle is that Uke always is the bad guy. He initiates the attack.
Okay.
And you respond.
Okay, any other questions? Okay, let's pair off.
We'll switch off so it doesn't matter who we are.